Hi viewer, I welcome you to Erim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Mathematics Form 3, lesson number 19. The topic it is sums. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us first of all look at our lesson goals today. We are going to do the rational and irrational numbers. We look at the sums. Then we look at how we can simplify the sums and how we operate the sums. Let's get started. The first thing you're going to look at, I know you have already mentioned about the natural numbers. We also have the fractions, the perfect squares, the perfect cubes, decimal numbers. We have talked about them, all of them. But there is something that we refer to it as rational and irrational numbers. Rational number is that number which can be written in the form of P divided by Q, where P and Q are integers, and Q is not equal to zero. P and Q should not have any other common factor other than one. So that is the number we refer to it as rational number. And these numbers are natural numbers, the ones that we talked about, fractions, perfect squares, perfect cubes, decimal numbers, both those that are terminating and those that are recurring. Now we go to the irrational numbers. Now when we talk about the irrational number, they are numbers that cannot be written in the form of P divided by Q. For example, we have pi. Pi cannot be written in the form of P divided by Q. And sand 2, sand 3, square root of 5, 3, sand 10. All those numbers and many others cannot be written in that form. That one gives us the irrational number. That is the reason as to why we come up with the topic of the sums. Because there are other numbers that we have not included in the mathematics. And that is when now we start to operate. Sums. Sums are numbers that don't have exact square roots or cube roots. For example, you have the ones that we have there, sand 2, sand 3, 3 sand. Not 3 sad, but the cube root of that is 6, cube root of 16. So we don't have exact square root. The sums are irrational numbers, while the number in the number under the root sign is a rational number. So you can be able to get that. The product of a sad and a rational number is called a mixed sad. Like the ones that you can be able to see them there. 2 sat 3, 4 sat 7, and that sat 2, and many others. Now, let us get the order of sums before we go to the operation. For example, we have the ones that we refer to them as order 2. These are the ones that are written in that form. Square root of 2, square root of 3, square root of 6, square root of 10. But the others that we refer to them as under 3, which are cube root of 2, cube root of 6, cube root of 10, cube root of 20. Then under 4 in that manner, that's how we get the under. That is the reason as to why you can see that point there. We said that the nth root of a number is the under of the set. We just get the examples. Now we start simplifying the sums. We have the first example, which is sand 18. It can be written as the factors. We get the factors. One must give us the perfect square root. For example, we have the square root of 9 times 2, which can be written as square root 9 times sand 2, which is 3 sand 2. 72, sand 72, it can be simplified in the form of sand 36 times sand 2, which is 6 sand 2. Then 200, it can be simplified to 10 sad 2. We go to the operation of sums. After simplifying the sad, now we can start operating them. And we are starting the first one, that is addition and subtraction of sums. Sums can only be added and subtracted if at all they are of the same order. And the number under the root is the same. Get that? Only the order must be the same and the number in the root must also be the same. We have the examples there. If at all we have the number outside, we put them in bracket and then from there we can operate them. Multiplication and division of sums. Sums of the same order can be divided, no matter whether that value that is in the root, inside the root, if at all they are different, they are the same, but they are of the same order. Like the examples that we have. Then we have sad, we open the bracket A plus or minus B. It is not the same as sad A plus or minus sad B. It is not the same. We have an example there. I have sad 2 plus sad 3. That is now operation general 1 squared. Can be seen as a sad 2. We open the bracket sad 2 plus sad 3. Then plus sad 3, sad 2 plus sad 3. After opening up the bracket, finally, we have the final answer as 5 plus 2 sad 6, because you are required to bring the right terms together. Remember, this operation we operate like the normal brackets, normal numbers. That is, the we also include the right terms and unlike terms. We bring them together. Activity for today, you are required to operate those numbers. That is sad 2 minus sad 3 in bracket sad 2 plus sad 3. Then number 2, it is you open the bracket to sad 3 plus sad 7. And then sad 3 plus 4 sad 11, you cross the bracket. For more information, reference, get the KRB 2003 Secondary Mathematics Student Book 3, that edition. You can also contact us through the SMS, get us from the YouTube, you can also get us from the Facebook, you can also get us or Twitter us. Otherwise, stay tuned to EdimTV. Thank you.